Welcome to the next session of quantity surveying estimation and evaluation. In last lecture, we have started the problems on approximate estimation, and in the continued with this, now we'll see another problem. Now this is the problem: prepare an approximate estimate for G plus 4 RCC building. Building cost of 6 flat on each floor, and each flat carpet area is 110 meter square. Then assume area occupied by walls and columns etc. as a 10% of a built up area, and area of circulation as a 20% of a built up area. Assume cost of construction as rupees 10,000 per square meter. Okay, so in this problem, what they have given? They have given one RCC building. RCC building having 5 floors, that is ground floor plus 4 floors, that is total 5 floors. Okay, and the building consists of 6 flat on each floor. Okay, so how many flats on in the building? So 6 flat into 5 floors, that is 30 flats, right? And the carpet area of one flat is 110 meter square. Okay, and they have given extra area for a walls and columns as a 10% of built up area. See here, they have given area of extra area for wall and column is a 10% of a built up area, not on a carpet area. It given as a 10% on a built up area, and area for circulation as a 20% on a built up area. Okay, so see the answer. Now G plus 4 story means 5 floors, okay, and 6 flats on each floor, means total number of flats is 6 into 5, that is 30 numbers. So the carpet area of one flat they have given as a 110 meter square. So the total carpet area is 30 flats into 110 meter square, that is 3300 meter square. So this is your total carpet area of a building, right? Now they have given extra area for walls and circulation on a built up area, not on a carpet area. So the built up area, that is plinth area, is equal to carpet area, then plus area for circulation and area for wall. Okay, so let us assume the built up area be x. We don't know the built up area. Okay, so we assume the built up area as x. Okay, and we have calculated the carpet area, that is 3300. So 3300 plus area for circulation is 20% on a built up area. Built up area we have assumed x. So 20x divided by 100, this is your area for a circulation, and area for wall is 10% on a built up area, means 10x divided by 100. Okay, so this equation becomes as a x is equal to 3300 plus 0.2x plus 0.1x. Okay, so then x is equal to 3300 plus 0.3x, right? Now this 0.3x is plus on this side, and it goes on this side, then it will become minus. Then x minus 0.3x is equal to 3300. So 0.7x, x minus 0.3x, that is 0.7x is equal to 3300, and x is 4714.29 meter square. So x is your built up area. So built up area of your building is 4714.29 meter square. Okay, so now we have calculated the built up area, that is plinth area. Okay, and they have given the cost for a built up area per square meter. Okay, they have given 10,000, that is the cost of construction per square meter. So the cost of building is built up area into the 10,000. Okay, then we will get the, this is the cost for building, that is 4,71,42,900 rupees, right? So this is the cost of building. Now we have to assume the cost for architectural treatment. They don't have given any cost for architectural treatment, then electric charges, or they don't have given anything. So we have to assume it. Okay, now what we have to assume, I will tell you after this problem. Now first is, one is your cost of architectural treatment. Okay, now we'll assume 1% of a building cost for a architectural treatment. So the 1% of 4,71,42,900 is 4,71,429 rupees. Okay, so water supply and sanitation, we are assuming 5% of a building cost. Okay, so this is the water supply and sanitation charges. Next one is your electric fitting charges. Now 12.5% of a building cost. Okay, so we have assumed 12.5% of a building cost, so it becomes electrical fitting charges, okay, and other services, that is 5% of a building cost. So this is the cost for other services. Now overall cost of building is your cost of construction, then architectural treatment, then electric fitting, okay, then other services and water supply and sanitation charges, okay. So all we add and 5,82,21,481.5 rupees is your overall cost of building, okay. Now we'll always apply contingency charges and supervision charges on overall cost of building, okay. So we'll assume the 3% as a contingency charges, 3% of overall cost, okay. So this is the amount for contingency charges, and supervision is 8% on a overall cost. So 8% on overall cost, so this is the amount of for a supervision charges. Now total cost of building is all the overall charges plus cost of contingency plus cost of supervision. So the cost of building is 6,46,25,844.8 rupees. So it becomes approximate 6,46,25,845 rupees. Okay, so this is the approximate cost of your building. Now see here, I've given one note. If the charges for a different items are not given in a problem, then you have to assume it. Okay, so what are the assumptions? The range for assumption is as follows. Okay, so architectural treatment, we have to assume architectural treatment as a 0.5 to 2% of a building cost. If someone has assumed 0.5, someone will assume 1%, someone will assume 1.5%, someone will assume 2%. Okay, that depends upon person to person. So approximate cost not be same for a person to person, that will be vary. Okay, so range is 0.5 to 2%. Don't assume beyond 2% or below the 0.5%. Okay, for architectural treatment, keep it in mind that the assumption is 0.5 to 2% of a building cost. Okay, then water supply and sanitation, 5 to 8% of a building cost. Okay, you can assume any figure between 5 to 8%. Then electric fitting is 10 to 15%. You can assume any figure between 10 to 15% for electric fitting. Then other services, assume 5% of building cost. Always take 5% of building cost for other services. Then contingency charges, 3 to 5% for overall cost. Okay, you can assume any figure between 3 to 5%, and supervision charges 8 to 10% of the overall cost. You have to assume all these charges if they have not mentioned in your problem. If they have mentioned in your problem, then whatever the figure they have mentioned, you have to take that figure for a calculating the other charges. Now if the only carpet area is given, then you have to assume the circulation area as a 20% to 30% of a built up area. In this problem they have given circulation area, assume 20% of a built up area. Okay, if they have not given, then you have to assume 20 to 30% area. Okay, and for a wall, 10 to 15% of a built up area you have to assume. Okay, if they have not mentioned. Now we'll see one another problem. Prepare an approximate estimation for a residential building in a western suburb of Mumbai, RCC frame structure. Okay, now they have given the plot area of building 60 meters by 30 meters, then FSI of this building is 1.5 meter. Okay, then building is G+3 RCC, right? Next, consider foundation cost as a 20% of a superstructure cost. See here, I have given one star mark here. I will explain why I have given star mark here. Consider foundation cost as a 20% of a superstructure cost. Okay, then allow 20% of a building cost for a other services. Then allow 2.5% of overall cost for consultancy. Then consider provision for 5% for a contingency. Okay, they have given 20% of building cost for all other expenses. Here, all other expenses. Now we will solve this problem. Now they have given plot area as a 60 meter by 30 meter, means what is the plot area? 1800 square meter is your plot area. Okay, now we know the FSI. FSI means floor space index. Okay, now I will calculate FSI. FSI is equal to total built up area divided by plot area. Okay, now what we know, we have to know that the built up area of building. Okay, so how will we calculate the built up area? Total built up area is equal to FSI into plot area. Okay. Now the FSI they have given as a 1.5, 1.5 into 1800. Then we'll get the total built-up area of a building is 2700 square meter. Okay. Now they are given the building is located in western suburb of Mumbai. Okay. So you have to assume the cost of construction. Now let us assume the cost of construction as a 10,000 for a superstructure. Okay. Why we are assuming 10,000 for a superstructure? Because they have given some extra 20% extra cost for a substructure, that is for a foundation. Okay. So cost of superstructure is 10,000 into built up area 2700. So 2,70,00,000 rupees. This is your cost of a superstructure. Now consider cost of foundation as a 20% of a superstructure. Right. Now the cost of foundation is 20% of superstructure, then that will become 54,00,000 rupees. This is the cost of your superstructure. Now always keep in mind that if they have given cost for superstructure, okay, or they have mentioned related to superstructure, then you have to always assume 20% cost for a foundation or substructure of a superstructure. That's why I have given the star mark there. If they have not mentioned, then you have to assume 20% cost for a substructure or a foundation. Okay, so this is the cost for foundation. Now cost for construction is superstructure cost plus foundation cost. Okay, so that becomes 3,24,00,000 rupees. This is the cost for construction. And cost for all other services, they have given all other services 20% of a building cost. Okay, so the all other services, the cost is 64,80,000. Okay, then overall cost is cost of all other services plus building cost, that is 3,88,08,000. Okay, they have not mentioned separately for cost for architectural cost, for electricity and sanitation. Okay, they have given overall cost as a 20% for all other extra services. Now cost for consultant is 2.5% of overall cost. They have given on overall cost, they will calculate the cost of consultant. Then contingency charges, they have given 5%. We'll calculate the contingency charges. Now we'll sum up all the values, then that will become 4,71,096,000. So this is your approximate cost. See here, star mark, I have given one. If foundation cost is not given, then assume 20% of a superstructure. Okay. So star mark is for this purpose. Okay. With this, I will stop here. We have again seen some another problems on approximate estimation, some different problems. Okay. And with this, I will stop here. Next lecture, we'll see some more problems. Thank you.